Michel Loreus, and I'm a high school teacher. I'm going to invite you to click on the symbol pi you can see just over here. I usually do videos in French, but today I decide to do this video in English. Why is that? It's just simple. It's because I'm experimenting. If you watch this video and you understand it, some people may think you're superhuman calculator. What is it exactly? This is a math trick. Let me show you the steps of the trick. What you have to do is just to tell one of your friends to take a calculator, for instance. And you will tell him to think about any number. It can be anyone. It can be a negative number, it can be a positive number, it can be an integer, and it can be as well a decimal number. Any number. Now you will tell your friend to take his calculator and to do some calculations. You will tell him to think of a number and to add this number to itself. In his calculator, he's gonna see a value. Remember, he will think of the number and he will not tell you what the number is. After that, you will tell him to multiply this value that he's seeing on the screen of his calculator by 4. Then, to take the new value, to add 56 to this value. Now, we're going to do a fourth step. In the fourth step, you will ask this friend to divide this new value by 8. Finally, he will find a value. And you will tell him at the last step to take the value that he chose from the beginning and to subtract it from the last value. And guess what? The answer is gonna be 7. The answer is 7, whatever the value your friend may have chosen. It doesn't matter at all. Let's talk to Mr. Bunny over here, and Mr. Bunny is gonna choose some random numbers, and we are going to put these numbers to the test. So, Mr. Bunny, I want you to choose 3 numbers. I want you to choose a negative number. I want you to choose a positive one. And the last one, it has to be a decimal number. So, what is the first number, Mr. Bunny? Mr. Bunny chooses minus 20. Step number 1. So, minus 20 plus minus 20 equals minus 40. Step number 2. Minus 40 times 4 equals minus 160. Step number 3. Minus 160 plus 56 equals minus 104. Step number 4. Minus 104 divided by 8 equals minus 13. Step number 5, the final step, minus 13 minus 20 equals 7, which is the result expected. Mr. Bunny chooses 115 as the second number. So this is the demonstration. And what is the last one, the decimal number? Mr. Bunny chooses 24.15 as the third number. And this is the proof that we get to the same result, which is 7. Why do we get to the same result whatever the number we may choose at the beginning? It's because, as you can see, the value 7 doesn't depend on this value that we can choose at the beginning. And the simplification of algebraic expression in high school helps to understand what's happening over here. Given that I'm talking about any number, means in algebra I'm talking about a variable. What exactly is a variable? Remember your high school math. A variable is a letter that can take an infinite number of values. I am going to do the mathematical demonstration that will explain how exactly I get to the value 7. So, step number one, I took x. X, this is the random number that your friend will choose. And you are telling your friend to add the number to itself. So it's x plus x. Step number two. This result in step number one is supposed to multiply it by 4. So we have 4 times x plus x. Step number three. You told your friend to take the result that he found in step number two and to add 56 to it. That's it. In step number four, you told him to take the result in step number three to divide it by 8. Step number four. In step number five, you told him to take the result in step number four and to subtract the original number from this algebraic expression found in step number four. So we have the algebraic expression in step number four minus x. And as you can see, when I simplify that expression, I will get to the point I will have x plus 7 minus x. That gives me x minus x, it's 0. Then what I have left over here is 7. So this is the explanation of the math trick. I hope you like this video. I am 100% convinced that you will impress your friends with this math trick. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and see you next time.